Hello, my name is Shinta. The underestimation of global catch is a major source of uncertainty in knowledge about the health of fish stock. An improved understanding on what causes this underestimation is clearly needed, especially in small and medium-scale fisheries. Indonesian tuna fisheries provide a strong case in point. The country is a major contributor to global tuna catch. Previous studies have identified illegal and unreported catch and problems in procedure around the collection of primary data as key source of uncertainty in the quality of fisheries data. In our study published in Fisheries Research, we identified the source of uncertainty. We looked at the operational level of data collection and quantified the major source of catch underreporting. We surveyed fishers in the oceanic fishing port of Bitung in North Sulawesi and then extrapolated our findings to the fishing port level by using logbook data. Our result revealed four categories of uncertainty. First, unreported catch of juvenile tuna. Second, the catch used as onboard consumption. Third, the catch brought home by the fisher for direct consumption. And fourth, the proportion of catch used as bait on handline fishing trips. We show that underreporting is particularly serious for catch of juvenile tuna. We estimate the total catch recorded in logbooks for vessels smaller than 100 gross tonnage is likely to be about 26 and 28% higher than the reported catch, just for juvenile tuna. Direct consumption of tuna, both at home and on board, amounts to about 5 to 6% of the total recorded catch. This consumption provides an important source of animal protein for households directly dependent on the fisheries. It could be part of the subsistence strategy of fishers with limited access to the alternative jobs. Our study also revealed two sources of uncertainty around catch and effort data. First, the accuracy of data reported by fisher to the fishing port authorities. The accuracy of fisher logbook is affected by the misunderstanding of what constitutes a catch to be reported, who is responsible for reporting, a distrust of the government by fisher, and fishing activities that are considered illegal. The second source of uncertainty comes from the poor accuracy of data management by the government. There is a lack of capacity and high turnover of data enumerators. There are also errors in data handling, a lack of error detection facilities, and databases that are constructed in formats that cannot be analyzed easily. Verification procedures of Indonesian catch and effort data reporting exist. However, these procedures are aimed at detecting illegal fishing, not to validate catch or effort reporting. The Ministry of Marine Affairs and Fisheries currently estimates catch to be around 11% higher than the reported landings. However, this proportion has no clear basis. We have found that this figure, for small and medium-scale fisheries at least, is more likely to be in the order of 33 to 38%, even when not considering possible non-reporting due to illegal fishing. Our results clearly show that the proportion of unreported catch varies between categories of unreported catch, gears, and the scale of the fisheries. Therefore, we suggest that the catch estimate should take account of different categories of type and scale of the fisheries. Our results are important for the Indonesian government as it plans to implement fishing quota. To do this, full documentation of total catch and fishing operation will be required. This will in turn mean that better procedure for catch reporting should be put in place. It also means that estimates of non-reporting should have a clear methodological basis. To help the government achieve this, we offer a practical method to quantify unreported catch, as well as in scaling up survey estimates to the port level.